I think in general, you know, everybody's watching what is happening between the US and China, but also what is happening between the US and Europe and some of the other markets. So Swiss companies being big exporters are in generally only indirectly affected. So I think this is the one to watch. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have a lot of exporters, very little companies which are just domestically active.
Well, we have ABB CEO, Mr. Spieshofer, recently told the Financial Times that if trade sanctions continued, it could lead to even layoffs in the U.S. So it seems that, you know, it really could hit home for Swiss companies.
I mean, that's definitely a big issue, especially for ABB. They have a big transformer business in the U.S., where they do local manufacturing. The other effect we're probably gonna see is if we look at ABB specifically, there is a lot of uncertainty among its big clients. So that means large orders, as they have been missing now for a while, could continue to miss in their order books.
And are there, do you see any other the companies in the industry sector, as we were saying, exporters, that could be affected by the sanctions in the U.S.? Any others?
I think
flag?
We only have, I mean, ABB is a big one. We have some smaller ones like Sulzer. More linked to oil and gas.
And Georg Fischer, maybe?
Georg Fischer is more linked to the automotive sector and a bit of, piping, so infrastructure building. Mm-hmm. So they're still doing well. But in terms of large orders, I think these are the two to watch.
And you have, so you recently held an event with, we had 50 companies, and you were looking at their outlooks. I mean, if we look at sectors, what sector is in the lead?
That's true. We recently held our Vontobel summer conference in Interlaken, a very beautiful town there.
It is very beautiful there.
We had 50 companies attending. In general, one can conclude that the small and mid-caps among the Swiss industrial companies still have a very good view on, let's say, the next couple of months. So they're pretty positive, pretty optimistic still.
Okay.
No clouds on the horizon.
Okay.
So that's
given all the clouds that are out in the world, there are none on their horizon.
So far, I think everybody was adamant in pointing out that they have seen a continuation of the good trends that we've seen towards the end of 17 and also in Q1 18. Mm-hmm. In my view, it's still important to keep an eye on what is happening because their lead times are usually rather short. The visibility is maybe 3 to 6 months. Markets tend to react earlier than, it becomes effective. So keep an eye on those.
And what about tech companies? What about Swiss tech companies?
I mean, we have few of them, okay? There are a couple of worldwide leaders in their respective niches, like Temenos, which is a core banking software player. We have Logitech, you know, the famous accessory companies. Mm-hmm. We have AMS, which is a semiconductor player, a big supplier to Apple, so basically moving up and down with the news flow of Apple.
Yeah.
But this is basically it. So they're still doing well, and they're not that much linked to, you know, general GDP growth. So we're still pretty optimistic about those.
So are we feeling like Switzerland is somehow a bit insulated from, you know, what's the other clouds, as we said, gathering in the horizons around the world? Are we still kind of safe here, Swiss companies?
Yeah, I wouldn't call it a safe place.
Who could feel this?
And you mentioned some of those, you know, industrial companies, which have a lot.
Okay, so goes back to ABB and these
Correct.
Guys. All right, well, what about other Swiss export-oriented companies like watches, for example?
Yeah, again, watches, you know, they are mainly linked to what is happening in some of the important emerging markets, you know, Hong Kong, Greater China. And here, you know, the rising middle class, you know, getting, you know, good jobs, having more disposable income. So you get a lot of new buyers. And this is a trend we have seen over the last couple of years, obviously rather on the higher end for Richemont, also doing very well in jewelry, and somewhat less on Swatch Group. So we clearly favor Richemont for this specific reason.
And then you can't talk about Switzerland, especially now in the summer, and not think of tourism. You've got the Jungfraubahn, you've got Titlis. I mean, is a stronger US dollar, a stronger euro helping here?
Definitely. I mean, we've seen some of those more tourism-related stocks doing particularly well, with the euro becoming a bit stronger against the Swiss, and the same for the dollar. You know, Switzerland is not that much of an expensive place anymore. Actually, we had a short period of time where basically it was the cheapest place to buy watches, you know, cheaper than, you know, some of the European countries. So everybody should come here to Switzerland. Jungfraubrunnen is worth a trip, definitely.
Well, if you ever want to leave your job at Vontobel, maybe you can knock on the door of the Jungfraubrunnen. And then last but not least, of course, we've got the banks, the insurers. They've been catching up. I mean, interest rates helping there too?
I think one has to differentiate on the insurers, you know, because they have a very long duration. It takes time until the higher interest rate environment, you know, feeds into the balance sheet and the P&L. It's more effective, you know, on large banks, because, you know, UBS and also Credit Suisse, Julius Baer, you know, they obviously benefit from a stronger euro, a stronger dollar, so that keeps margins higher on their assets. So we clearly favor UBS is the, let's say, a bit more defensive business model.
All right, but overall, we've got a good feeling. General feeling is positive, not too many clouds on the horizon. I assume you're going to be waving that Greek flag in just a few days.
Well,
or the Swiss.
Well, rather the Swiss. The Greeks aren't really playing, so.
But, you know, it brings out patriotism in everyone, right? Suddenly.
Correct, yes.
Yes, but the Swiss flag for sure. Thank you so much for being with us, Takis.
Thank you.